Welcome back to the 12 Goals of Christmas, everybody. We are nearing the end of our countdown. I'm still using the moniker Bramsey Claus here that I started this thing with, even though we, you know, Christmas is in the whale in the rear view. I mean, we might as well start thinking about next Christmas at this point if we get there, because we always are looking forward on this show, except when we're looking back, which is right now. So one of my favorite musical artists is Cat Stevens. I'm more of a later Cat Stevens type of guy. I'm not huge into like early Cat Stevens necessarily, but I do think one of his early hits is a great one, later covered by Sheryl Crow. And it says, "The first cut is the deepest. I'll try to love again, but I know." And that's what I started thinking of when I started thinking about this goal. Number 10 on our countdown is the very first goal that we scored of the season. The first cut is the deepest. This is a goal that just really made us kind of think. If you remember when the season started, when the 2023 season started on the Charlotte Soccer Show, I will cop to this. You know, I won't blame John as much as I will blame myself, is that I was very overconfident. I thought Charlotte FC was amazing. I thought we were going to go win the league. I thought we had so much talent and we were just going to maximize it and go out and like shake things up and crush the world and dominate and everything. And I was quickly disabused of that notion in this very game that I'm about to show you. But the most painful and teasing thing about it, this is a game that we lost 3-1, but we were up 1-0 after this goal, our first goal of the season. And so this first goal of the season sort of like was a little bit of like a teaser, a taster of like me thinking that I might have been right, that maybe Charlotte FC is great and maybe this is amazing. So maybe this is, you know, going to be all my overconfidence will be justified and rewarded. You know, the first cut is the deepest. And this one cut me pretty deep for sure.
5 shots so far for St. Louis. Charlotte yet to take one, but maybe an opportunity here. Juszczyk with Capetti running. Goes wide to Sweet Airscape. Sweet Airscape looking for Capetti. Oh, it's in! Enzo Capetti, the first goal in City Park history, comes from the visitors. The newest addition to Charlotte FC opens his account and puts Charlotte ahead 1-0.
But for Charlotte FC to have a big-time 2023 year, the front three have to deliver. Juszczyk, Swiderski, and then a wonderful ball in for Capetti to get on the end of it. So much of what Capetti looks like and feels like is what Tati Castellanos was for New York City FC. And if there is a Tati goal, there is one right there. 25 minutes in, 1-0, Charlotte FC here in St. Louis.
What a week it's been for Enzo Capetti. He and his wife welcomed their daughter Mia on Wednesday.
Shout out to Mia. Mia Capetti, the legend. Approaching her first birthday, coming up in a couple months. So, yeah. So, man, what a goal. It's a beautiful goal. First off, it's a beautiful goal. It's a lovely service from Carol. It's a nice just little flicked on header from Enzo. Good work from Camille in the setup and the buildup. Tuiloma even contributed on that goal. As Taylor mentioned, it's our three DPs. It's our front three, you know, like combining on a bing, bang, boom, you know, assist goal, double assist, secondary to Camille. And I just thought, man, like what it was three of our guys running at six of their guys, which I thought, you know, like you don't even necessarily realize that until you go back and watch it again. But like, it's like we really had a lot to be encouraged by on this thing, and then it all turned south on us. So I think that's why it hurts so bad and why it's, you know, as Cat Stevens saying, "I'll try to love again, but I know," like, I believed when I saw this happen, I honestly believed we were going to win the league. I thought Capetti was going to lead the league in goals scored. And they believe it too. Like, Capetti's pointing, like, these guys are like, you know, looking at each other. Ashley's like, "Yeah, this is amazing." Like, Carol's like, "Oh, this is, you know, this is what we do here." You know, "Oh, like, yeah, I knew you could do that." You know, it's just like so funny. Like, three of our guys running at six of theirs, and Capetti finds the space. Carol picks him out. You know, I mean, it's beautiful. Like, what happened is all I can say. When I see this, I'm just like, where did it all go wrong after from this point forward? Because You know, we obviously lost this match 3-1. They got a weird own goal that Klaus celebrated, and we started playing like crap. And it's just funny, like it just illustrates, like, again, I have the bias of I just recently, you know, to start this whole project, this 12 goals project, I went back and watched all 60 goals in a row in order that Charlotte FC scored. So I'm a little bit biased by the fact that I've seen all this great play of what Charlotte FC can be and like what we were at our best last season. And so I, you know, again, if I went back and watched film of all the goals, I don't have to go back, by the way, I don't have to go back and watch a tape of all the goals that were scored against us. They don't have to find that on Apple TV. I just go to the MLS countdown of top 10 goals of the season, and they were all scored against us. So there you go. So, you know, all the signs point to positive regression in terms of we can't give up so many golosos and bangers again. Our defense has to be better. We can't lose so many leads. Like, there's so many times I made this list. So, right. So, like you'll see the full list at some point. But I made this list, and I made, like, little notes. Each goal, like, when it was scored, who scored it, the assists, and little notes and stuff like that. And just, like, every time I had to fill in this, like, result column of, like, you know, what happened in the game, you know, I was like, God, man, we had so many leads. And we were up 2-0 so many times and 1-0 and, you know, late goals that should have been winners, you know, not Scott Arfield's winner. Scott Arfield's winner in Nashville, that thankfully, you know, nothing bad happened after that one, after I blacked out. But, yeah, so it was rough. And this was the first time that happened as far as surrendering a late lead. We did surrender a late tied position against New England the previous match to this. But this was not a late lead. We surrendered an early lead. Oh, man. I could have given you all of my love. As they sang, the first cut is the deepest. So I'm going to try to love again, and we're going to try to figure it out with Enzo, maybe Carroll, maybe Camille, maybe none of them. Maybe, you know, we just replace them all with Ajmal and Cambridge and Vargas, and everybody will be happier at that point. Who knows? But this was a goal that belongs on the countdown, but I don't feel great about it.